I'm being frank with you. Sunday morning, and I've had a bit of an early start. I said last week that the car park machines are very intelligent and they tell you when they've broken down. But sometimes people tell you when they've broken down and they haven't actually broken down. The story is, yesterday I got a call from a roving supervisor who told me that he had had calls that the machines were not working, so he'd gone to the car park, and this particular car park, he put bags over the machines so that people did not have access to them, which means that they can park free. So I get up early this morning, I go to the machines, and he's right, the first machine, it was out of order, just a small repair, a reboot of the system, and it was working. I took the bag off the second machine, and it was working perfectly. He had not even bothered to test it. So it's been a bit of a wasted effort diving in there for no real reason, because as long as one machine is working, the car park is active and it collects money for the owner. So I got up at 6 o'clock on a Sunday morning, not my usual practice, and now I'm back home. It is now 9:30, and I suppose I can just do some things in the garden. Although the weather is not looking really all that good. On my way back, the sunshine was very good, and I thought, good, I can spend some time in the garden. But now I look at the sky and I see clouds coming over the hills, and I think it's just going to be another of these days of sunny showers. Anyway, let's see how it goes. So, the first task that I'm going to do this morning is paint this shed. It's got a little bit weathered over the winter and the summer, and it's good to actually get some of the paint protected, the wood protected is what I mean to say. I don't really have very much of the timber care product, but what little I have, I'm going to use it up.
We had a barbecue in Saint-Tropez in May, with some friends drinking booze, getting all loose. We drove the cars to the beach on the outside of the street, sat around a bonfire, eating marshmallows all night. You people young at time, I know it, but you were so damn fine, couldn't get you on my mind. We were young at time, I know it, but I wanted something more than you.
Half an hour later, and you can see where I've run out of paint. It's stupid really, because if I'd known I was doing this today, I was passing the shop that sells the timber care products, so I could have bought it there. Ah well, I can always pick it up through the week and continue the job next weekend. I was out weed killing, and then the roofer came to take away his trailer, so I had to move the car. And then he took 20 minutes to explain to me the real problems of trying to make our roof look good again. Everything is the fault of the person who did the extension and some small repairs around the roof, and he's having to put them, make them good again. So that was an interesting 20 minutes. Now I'm clearing a drain. This is the drain that takes all the water from the driveway and puts it into the drainage system. But unfortunately, I don't know if the camera can see down the hole, it's still blocked. Well, it is blocked. We have had some render taken away from the base of the garage, and it's going to be refinished. But the render has found its way down the drain. Oh, nice, I've just seen that the ants are down there too. So this could be an interesting exercise.
Well, like most of the drains around our house, I've no idea where it actually goes to, where it flows to. But it's been a messy job getting it clear. Let's go see if this works.
Well, there's a repair that seems to have worked. It's been running for about 10 minutes. The pipe is not filling up. That's a good sign. There goes my wife, abandoning me again. I have to make my own lunch. It's a hard life.
It's about 11:30 and we're all shutting down for the night. Sorry, I got distracted there because the phone said something about using a microphone. I don't know what it was saying. It was an interesting day. Oh yes, tonight my wife's car alarm went off on two different occasions.
And we went out and looked at the car the first time. Didn't see anything wrong, nobody trying to break into it, anything like that. And then the second time I thought, maybe it's something inside. My son found a moth in the back of the car. So the moth must have been going across the detectors and set off the alarm. So all's well that ends well. It's been a good weekend. Hope yours was too. More next week. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.